This is Connelly Gonzalez, and welcome to your Information Security Newspaper channel. What is Jitsi? Is it secure? Well, it's certainly more secure than Zoom, and it has actually been recommended by Edward Snowden. Here, we will tell you everything about it. Jitsi is a very attractive, unlimited group video calling service. It offers multiple options, free of charge, and you won't even have to register to use it. Jitsi is a new application, a new alternative to all those video calling services that have become so popular during this isolation period. And it stands out among other tools because it's a free multi-platform tool that allows to make video group conferences through the internet. This means that you won't even have to install anything or create an account to use Jitsi. There's not even a sign-in option on the top. Users can write a username to be identified, but it's not required. And even though, just as Zoom, Jitsi meetings are not end-to-end encrypted, they are decrypted on the server that hosts them. And here, you can actually act as a server yourself. You can also log into your Google account, and this will be used by Google Analytics, but it's not required. It's only optional, and the company explains on its website that it's only used to know which functions are used the most and if there are any potential errors. So how does Jitsi make money if they are not selling my data? It doesn't make sense. I'm not giving them my email, my name, and in most cases, not even data that Google can analyze and commercialize. Well, Jitsi is actually financed by a company called Atlassian and 8x8, a project by the same company, so it's free for that community. So besides being free, Jitsi truly stands out for its simplicity. When you enter the website, you only have to paste the URL or the name of the group. If it doesn't exist, you will create it, and if it does exist, you will join it. In the mobile app, as soon as you open the application, you can create or join a group. In both cases, without having to create an account. And of course, you can create a password for your meeting, because otherwise, anyone with that URL or with the name of the meeting could crash in. Calls can be video or voice, and in addition to providing you with a personalized web address, each meeting will have a phone number so you can join it without having to be in front of a computer. It also has the optional features of recording the call with Dropbox or broadcasting it live in YouTube. And of course, Jitsi offers basic options like a text chat, or an option to raise your hand to speak orderly, or an option to mute everyone when someone else is speaking, etc. So let's explore Jitsi. It's simple. You just have to go to jitsi.com and type the URL or the name of the meeting. Or if you want to create a new group or a new meeting, just type it. When the video call starts, it looks like this. We divided it in four parts so it's clear. Number one, on the bottom left corner, there are three options. From left to right, they are share your screen, raise your hand, and open the text chat. Number two, on the bottom middle. Here you have the options to activate or deactivate your microphone, hang up and close the chat, and activate or deactivate your camera. Number three, on the bottom right corner, here there are three icons that serve to change the full screen view. Obtain information such as the link or the number of the meeting, or put a password, and a three-point button that opens even more options. Number four, on the upper right corner, you can see the quality of your camera, and if you click on me, you can set a username. Now, here's what appears when you click on the three dots on the bottom right corner. You can record the conversation or mute everyone. There's also a settings option where you can change the input of your camera and microphone. Write your username or link the meeting to Google Calendar if you wish to. Also on that same corner, when you click on the eye, a window will show you the methods of accessing this meeting, such as the URL. Here is also the option to add a password so there are no intruders. On a mobile, the process is even simpler. Once inside the app, the interface is even more minimal, with a three-point button that displays all the options. I hope you find value in this information. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Click on the bell button. My name is Connelly Gonzalez, and I wish you the very best.